Hey guys, MA63 here from Not So Daily Gaming, and we're back with another tutorial in the Cessna C172P. So I figured that if we're gonna keep up our just constant thing, I figured I'd show you how to start the engine. So we're gonna go through the checklist, kind of show you where everything is. The Cessna is a really fun aircraft to fly with, and it has a lot of really cool and unique features. So I figured might as well go over some of them. So we're going to just go ahead and assume that we have relatively full tanks, batteries charged. Obviously, there's a couple things you need to do if that's not the case, obviously. But we'll go with that. So pre-flight inspection, we're going to assume that we have the parking brake, blah, 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 blah. Everything is off, and we're going to go ahead. Technically, we're supposed to walk out of the aircraft and look and make sure everything's okay, but I think we can do that if I just go like so. You can see our airplane, oops, it's a little lag there, is beautiful. There I am. I think, am I a girl? I appeared in, maybe, I can't tell. Anyway, but there I am there. It's quite a beautiful view, just here in Washington Dulles Airport, or wherever it is. It looks great. So, let's go back inside. We've successfully done all that. Before starting engine, it told us to put the battery on. That's the one on the right, and you'll notice that the voltage immediately dropped. We've done that, don't need to worry about that. We have everything, we're just going to assume everything looks fine. Starting engine, here's where it's hard, complex. Okay, so our flashing beacon is this one. And that's important because it lets other aircraft know. If we go out here, you'll see that, hey, we actually have an engine running. This is the primer. So basically, prime the engine, fill it with stuff, just so we have that. So we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll say 4 is enough. Carburetor heat does need to be cold. Just does it there. Okay, throttle open a little eighth of an inch. I find it helpful to have the checklist up when I do this because I know it's going to be correct. Typically, I mean, I could just do this, right? I'm using my joystick here to adjust the throttle to position and about an eighth of an inch open, but we'll just go like that and see where it turns green on the checklist. We know that it's perfect. The mixture starts when you first start the aircraft. It starts at zero. But you want to go all the way to 100%. By the way, in case you didn't know this, if you have a mouse that has a middle button where you can scroll, the scroll wheel will adjust on most aircraft where it is. And like for the Magneto, we'll get into that in a second. We can do that. All right. So we can either press this, the right bracket, squirrely bracket key 3 times, or we can just use our thing to go to both, which is awesome. Ignition switch. Okay. So at this point, we can now use the ignition switch, so everything's ready to go. So we'll press, I'm holding S right now, and the airplane started right up, and you can hear that, which is great. And so now we're going to turn on the alternator, which basically says, hey, we are now charging the battery with the engine because it started. We can go ahead and turn on avionics power, so that gives power to all our radios and everything. And we're just going to turn on our strobe, our navigation lights, we don't need pilot heat. Taxi lights, landing lights off, taxi lights on, sure, why not? Okay, great. And now we're ready to go. That was literally it. So before takeoff, everything's fine. And that's basically all you need to know. Something you should look at is, so this is kind of a cool thing that they have you do. So if we look at, currently I'm at idle, right? So let's go up to about 20,000. I think that's where they want you, so we'll go 15. So let's go like 15,000, like right there on the money. Okay, close enough. Now, if we go back to left, we should drop RPM back to both, climbs again. If we go to right, should drop. And basically what that's ensuring is that we're not just going off of one magneto. And if the RPM doesn't drop, it means that one of them is stuck on, and that's even potentially more dangerous than not one of them not working, because they're basically like spark plugs. But yeah, we're ready to go. So I think everything is good to be tuned on. Worth noting that we should change our altimeter, although you really should listen to the radio. We're just going to change that to 0 feet, just so we have that. And I think we'll change... That's fine. Get our yokes. We'll hide those there. But we can see that. Yeah, so here's where you can kind of cheat a little bit and see your battery charge. So you'll notice that if the battery charge is 100% right now, but if I turn off the alternator, you'll notice how it starts dropping. actually pretty rapidly. The alternator is making sure, if I turn back on again, is keeping sure the battery is fully ready to go. So, at this point, we are ready to go. And also, and I will turn off parking brake and just get going down the field. The clock is nice because it keeps track of how many hours I've been in the airplane. So at this point, I've been in the airplane for 2 hours, I think that is. How long the engine has been running, which is kind of cool to have that. We should probably put some flaps down. Not all Cessnas have automatic flaps that go down to a set position. Sometimes you just kind of have to guess. No gear in the Cessna though, so that's fine. So we'll get going up here. And that's basically it. Yeah, so just a quick 5-minute video explaining how to do that. How to start a Cessna 172. So thank you guys all very much for watching. This has been another video by EMH233. If you guys have any suggestions for tutorials or other things I should cover in flight gear that nobody has covered enough yet, which I know there are a whole bunch of things, feel free, drop down, let me know. I would be more than willing to cover them, because I think it's important for the community in order to be prepared to have all these tutorials out there for newcomers and other people. It's useful. And yeah, so anyway, thank you guys all very much for watching. I'll catch you guys later. Bye-bye.